हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट जैन ऑस्टिन एज आर नॉवलिस्ट। क्या आज का हमारा टॉपिक है जैन ऑस्टिन का। जैन ऑस्टिन वॉज द ग्रेटेस्ट वुमेन नॉवलिस्ट ड्यूरिंग द फर्स्ट क्वार्टर ऑफ 19th century। जैन ऑस्टिन जो हैं वो महान वुमेन नॉवलिस्ट रही हैं 19th century की। शी रोट 6 novels इन ऑल, इन्होंने टोटल 6 novel लिखे हैं। येट ऑल ऑफ देम वियर द स्टैम्प ऑफ हर क्राफ्ट एंड आर्टिफिश। इन हर लिमिटेड रेंज शी हैज परफॉर्म्ड मिरेकल्स एंड सो ऑफन हर नेम इज कंपेयर्ड विद शेक्सपियर। रॉबर्ट लिडिल डिस्पेरेज एंड ऑल्सो सपोर्ट्स हर कंपेरिजन विद शेक्सपियर व्हेन शी रिमार्क्स। जैन ऑस्टिन इज ऑफन एंड वेरी इनएप्टली कंपेयर्ड विद शेक्सपियर। इट इज हार्ड टू सी हाउ एनीवन who sincerely admired either of them could make that comparison or could suppose that they were trying to do the same thing. His handling of character and intrigue is often no more impressive than all her verbal poetry. बायोग्राफी पढ़ते हैं। जैन ऑस्टिन वॉज बॉर्न ऑन 16th December 1775। इनका जो बॉर्न हुआ है 16 दिसंबर को हुआ है एट स्टीवेंशन इन हैम्पशियर वेयर हर फादर द ड्यू जॉर्ज ऑस्टिन वॉज द एक्टर। हर मदर वॉज कैसिन लिली। जैन ऑस्टिन डाइड ऑन जुलाई 18th 1817। इनकी जो एजुकेशन है वो फ्रॉम 1783 टू 1785। जैन एंड कैसेंडर अटेंड स्कूल इन ऑक्सफोर्ड एंड साउथहैम्पटन एंड एवरी स्कूल एट रीडिंग। ऑस्टिन कुड नो लॉन्गर एफर्ड द ट्यूशन। जैन एंड कैसेंडर रिटर्न होम टू रीड एक्सटेंसिवली। शी लर्न इट फ्रॉम देयर फैमिली हाउ टू स्पीक फ्रेंच एंड इटेलियन एंड प्ले द पियानो। हर फादर केप्ट अ लार्ज कलेक्शन ऑफ लिटरेचर इन हिज होम लाइब्रेरी। जैन एंड हर सिस्टर बोथ हैड परमिशन टू यूज लाइब्रेरी एंड गेट बेनिफिट्स फॉर द बुक्स। जैन ऑस्टिन्स आउटलुक। शी वॉज नॉट अ विक्टोरियन। वो विक्टोरियन नहीं थी। शी वॉज अ काइंड ऑफ पर्सन हु सेल्डम ग्लैंस्ड टू पास्ट और फ्यूचर। She neither wished to startle the world with revolutionary achievements. She took her world as she found it, wishing for nothing better. She would have found little jest in an ideal world. Theme in her work: morality, religion, politics, property, and class. Jane Austen was one of the supreme artists in fiction. She was a highly sophisticated artist with all scrupulosity that is associated with a neat and clean artist. In the opinion of W.L. Cross, she is one of the sincerest examples in our literature of art for art's sake. She wrote her novels with care, constantly revising and then allowing a full 12 months for each final rewriting before publication. Arnold Cattle says she was a serious and conscious writer, absorbed in her art, wrestling with its problem, casting and recasting her material, transferring her novel from letter of narrative form. Restoring her subject matter with meticulous economy, she had the great artist's concern with form and presentation. Aesthetic quality in Jane Austen. Mr. Knightley, I wonder what will become of her. Mrs. Norris is one who makes a very strong first impression. She is writing the pure novel as if Jane Austen did, concentrating upon human beings and their mutual reactions. What is particularly noticeable in the case of Jane Austen is her artistic craftsmanship as a novelist. As a master of her craft, she outshined all contemporary novelists in poetic limitations. Jane Austen defined her boundaries and never stepped beyond them. She had a narrow experience, but she adopted an entirely different attitude towards it. She adjusted her vision and focused it to a very small perspective. She chose the microscopic method of observation. In the mental as in the physical vision of every human being, there is a blind spot. It is a common place of criticism that here are regional novels as truly as Hardy's or Arnold Bennett's, but her restrictions were conscious and deliberate to maintain the authenticity guaranteed by her own observation and inseparable from it the aesthetic unity of her artifacts. She drew all her material from her own experience. She never went outside her experience, with the result that all her scenes belong to South England, where she had spent a considerable period of life. Jane Austen's style is strongly antithetic. Her style in Pride and Prejudice, dramatic irony, and showed equal command. Jane Austen is a satirist as well as moralist. In Sense and Sensibility, she satirizes too much of sentimentality. In the character of John Dashwood, she satirizes hand-picked husbands. In the character of his wife, she finds nothing but contempt for her selfishness. Jane Austen does not idealize her characters. She presents her characters with all their warts and foibles, their vices and virtues. It is the most important consequence of her consistently characters have their faults. And what is more striking, she shows as how these faults are integral to their natures. Jane Austen's characters are never reformed. They remain themselves, only them. Have or have not learned some sense and will be more careful in future. Austen's published writing. Sense and Sensibility 1811 में पब्लिश हुई है. जो उनकी राइटिंग्स हैं, प्राइड एंड प्रेजुडाइस 1813 में, मैंसफील्ड पार्क 1814 में, और एमा 1815 में, परसुएशन 1817 में, और नॉर्थएंगर एवे 1817 में. ऑस्टेंस के माइनर राइटिंग्स हैं जुवेनिलिया, लव एंड फ्रेंडशिप, लेडी सूसन, द वॉटसन्स एंड सैंडिशंस. जेन ऑस्टेन एन इंग्लिश नॉवलिस्ट हुज वर्क्स ऑफ रोमांटिक फिक्शन सेट अमंग द लैंडेड जेंट्री अर्नड हर अ प्लेस एज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट वाइडली रीड राइटर्स इन इंग्लिश लिटरेचर. Her realism, biting irony and social commentary have gained her historical importance among scholars and critics. Jane Austen's writing style. Jane Austen's distinctive literary style relies on a combination of parody, mockery, irony, free indirect speech and a degree of realism. She used parody and mockery for comic effect and to critique the portrayal of women in 18th century sentimental and gothic novels. Irony is one of Austen's most characteristics and most discussed literary techniques. Austen is most renowned for her development of free indirect speech, a technique pioneered by 18th century novelist Henry Fielding and Francis Verney. Austen's have little narrative or scenic descriptions. They contain much more dialogue, whether spoken between characters, written as free indirect speech, or represented through letters. Austen's novels have variously been described as a politically conservative and progressive. थीम इन हर वर्क, इनके वर्क की थीम क्या रही है? एजुकेशन एंड रीडिंग रही है, मोरलिटी रही है. एजुकेशन एंड रीडिंग, ऑस्टेंस प्लॉट आर फंडामेंटली अबाउट एजुकेशन. हर हीरोइंस एक्सपीरियंसेस अ प्रोसेस थ्रू विच दे कम टू सी क्लियरली देमसेल्फ एंड हर देयर कंडक्ट एंड देयर वाई बिकम बेटर पीपल. मोरलिटी क्या है? इनकी करेक्टराइज्ड बाय मैनर्स, ड्यूटी टू सोसाइटी एंड रिलीजियस सीरियसनेस इज अ सेंट्रल थीम ऑफ ऑस्टेंस वर्क. रिलीजन, जेंडर और पॉलिटिक्स. रिलीजन है, ऑस्टेंस वॉज अ हार्ड वर्किंग एंड बिलीविंग church woman, so religion we can see in her work. Gender, Austen's fiction female characters comment on male author text and take change charge of the creation of their own words. Politics, Austen highly influenced by politics, so in her major work we find theme of politics. Her woman characters are quite complex. The young ladies who figure prominently in her novels are quite intricate and complex. They are more intricately conceived than those of any English novelist before George Eliot. Emma provides the study of woman who is a mixture of vanity. Jane Austen had a knack in portraying moral aspects of her characters. Indeed, Jane Austen's understanding of the moral nature of man is, within the limitation of her experience, complete. She what she knew exactly who was bad and discriminated. Exactly the individual shade of their goodness or badness. Exactly perceived how it showed itself in their behavior. Nothing escapes her, nothing baffles her, nothing deceives her. Yep. All her heroines are touched with the comic spirit. Emma, Elizabeth, Annie, Elliot are creature of flesh and blood and are able to laugh if not be laughed at. Thank you for watching.